Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Kingdom Plantae. In that we are studying topic Botanical Gardens. You all must have visited a normal garden. Now what is this botanical garden? Let's try and study about this. When I say botanical garden, a garden that will have botanical species, the definition says that. Now botanical gardens are basically constructed for in situ conservation of various medicinal herbs, plants and species which are endangered or which are almost on the verge of extinction or which have great role in studies or in observations. For example, if you visit a botanical garden anywhere around India or abroad, you will never see any normal plant which you find every day in a botanical garden. Botanical gardens try to preserve in their exact natural environment species which are in danger, which are about to distinguish or which hold a great medicinal or research properties. For example, if you visit a botanical garden of aloe vera or tulsi, you will find all the tulsi varieties in that botanical garden with the scientific name and their functions and their properties and the research is done on them. Even for different species or for different, whether it is angiosperm, whether it is gymnosperms, you will find different amounts and different categories in this botanical gardens. Now, botanical gardens are a major source of studies for scientists whenever they want to study evolutionary studies or classification studies or taxonomy studies on plants. They find their way to a botanical garden. Even students who are doing research or even companies who deal with Ayurvedic products have a great care or cater to botanical gardens in India or in abroad. Now, there are various botanical gardens, majority of them located in Kolkata and other states of the country. The largest botanical garden, if I talk about in the world, is the Royal Botanical Garden, and it is extended approximately around 200 acres of land. That's huge, and it will have almost all the species that are present in and around the periphery. In India, one of the biggest botanical gardens that is located is in Kolkata, and the Indian Botanical Garden at Kolkata has various species which are in endanger or very rare species of plants just preserved in the natural or in situ environment over there. Botanical gardens. Now, if I talk about botanical gardens are very different from your normal gardens. Your normal gardens will have different types of plants without any order, without any preference, just planted for beauty purpose and for respiration and playing. But botanical gardens do follow a pattern. The botanical gardens are constructed for in situ, or you can say in place, in natural environment, in and around soil and a natural being for conservation of plant species. Now this plant species could be angiosperm, gymnosperms, bryophytes, pteridophytes, anything it could be, which is important to mankind, even for studies and for the nation. And it is used for later identification purpose, especially during evolutionary studies or during endangered species or rare species of plants. The identification is very important. according to the red data book. Each plant is labeled with its scientific name, and we all know that the scientific name that includes the genus name and the species name, which is also given by binomial nomenclature by Carl Linnaeus, is very important for plants in botanical garden, and from which family do they belong, whether they are an angiosperm, whether they are a gymnosperm, pteridophyta, bryophyta, what is their category. That's labeled in a botanical garden for reference purpose and for smooth studies. Now, the famous botanical garden in India would be located in Kolkata, and it is famous for its various trees or herbs or shrubs that are planted, which have great medicinal values, great ecological, scientific research values, along with a banyan tree, which is approximately 200 years old. And there is a lot of researchers going in and around this banyan tree. Now, students, I hope you all have got a clear picture of what a normal garden would consist of and what a botanical garden would consist of. The only difference here in normal garden is that you would find any random plants, whether it is herbs, shrubs, tall trees, flowering plants, in any order and grown in any fashion without any source reason for use it as a scientific investigation. Whereas for botanical gardens, the whole and sole purpose are the aim for scientific evolution, for scientific studies, for finding out their progenies, for hybridization experiments, even for genetic experiments, botanical garden plants are used. I hope, students, you all are clear with this concept of botanical garden. Thank you.